Hello? I did a gig recently. It was at a conference for young farmers. Well, I'd had a bad leg, pulled a muscle at the back. So I thought, I'll tell them about that. It's the worst that can happen. So I'm standing there, in front of all these young farmers. And I said to them, I fucked me calf. Well, I got a standing ovation for it. Suppose I should have opened with, I've got a basic knowledge of castration. Well, read a magazine article once. Didn't even read the whole article, just a bit of it about castration. A snippet. My younger brother once castrated a sheep with a pair of spoons. It wasn't deliberate. So he's trying to play the spoons, but he was quite clumsy when he was little. I remember it was worst when he tried to wipe his arse. He was so cack-handed. Now, Adolf Hitler's mother was from a family of shepherds. German shepherds. And she used to play the spoons, although she only had one spoon. Do you know the plural of cervix? It's services. Now, I came here on the motorway tonight. Gives a whole new meaning to the Watford Gap. I actually came here from Stoke-on-Trent. Now, the way I like to describe Stoke-on-Trent to anyone that doesn't know it, it's a bit like Paris. By that I mean, there's dog shit everywhere in the streets. Well, for those of you that don't know Paris, there's dog shit everywhere in the streets. It's a bit like Stoke. Now, I've started to notice quite a lot of broken glass in Stoke, on top of all the dog shit. Not literally on top of it. Well, that'd be dangerous, wouldn't it? Although, it would actually be less dangerous if they were both in the same place. Might mention that to the council. It could make some savings. Cuts, I believe it goes. Oh. I got into a fight the other day. Oh no, that's not right. It's Fiat. I got into a Fiat. Ed Balls, his wife, Yvette Cooper. She pronounces her name Yvette, which is presumably why she didn't take her husband's surname. But I reckon Ed Balls would have made a great deputy leader of the Labour Party. But only if Sandwell councillor Keith Alcock was elected as the leader. Exactly, yeah. Who wouldn't vote for Alcock and Balls? I know I would. But when I heard there was a massive split in the Labour Party, I thought Katie Hopkins had joined them. Now, I used to do that joke with Katie Price instead of Katie Hopkins, but I was accused of being sexist. Because apparently, Katie Price actually does have a massive vagina. Who'd have known? But I'm not sexist. I can't be sexist. Some of my ex-wives were women. Now, the reason that Margaret Thatcher was cremated, this is what I heard. They didn't want all the piss on the grave seeping into the coffin. Well, it might reanimate the corpse. And the last thing anyone would want is a Thatcher piss zombie wreaking havoc on the world. The first time was bad enough. So anyway, got into a Fiat. We are Geordie. Kicked the living shit out of me. I went past Wetherspoons earlier. Why is it outside Wetherspoons there's always what can only be described as Jeremy Kyle's street theatre going on? Well, when I went past earlier, there was this woman in a tracksuit. Sort of horrible orange colour it was. Tracksuit was purple. She was screaming across the street at this other woman. Things like bitch, slag, whore, what's for tea, mum? Excuse me. When did Punch from Punch and Judy get replaced by Richard? Smack, crack, poppers. It's what Pete Doherty has in his Rice Krispies. Now, Dr. Kellogg of Kellogg's Rice Krispies fame, he used to run a mental asylum. And back in the day, 90% of admissions were for excessive masturbation. Consider it a kind of finishing school for boys. Now, Dr. Kellogg, his expertise, he was a dietitian, and he believed with the right nutrients, you could suppress the sexual urge, which is how he came up with cornflakes. Now, I've never seen anyone eating a bowl of cornflakes whilst masturbating. So they do work. Paul McCartney says he quite often writes songs sitting on the toilet. Well, I wonder, does he know it's going to be a number one? Because I once wrote a song stood at a urinal, and I knew immediately I had number one on my hands. Unlike my younger brother, remember the cack-handed one? Well, he's never written a song, so it's never been an issue. I was at a celebrity pool party when who walked in but Michael Barrymore? Yeah. Could have died. Now there's this bloke who's always outside of our space, Pigeon Man to go. He sits on his bench, gets out his bag of seed, and he feeds the birds and they come and land on him. It's quite a spectacle. Well, that's not why they call him Pigeon Man. He got the name Pigeon Man when he was caught taking a shit on somebody's car. Well, I only found out about that the day after I lent him my car. That's not actually as bad as it sounds, because it wasn't really my car. It was my mate Mickey's. Mickey Two Eyes, you call him. He's got two eyes. But there were three musical pigeons. Coo, coo, coo. Come on and do the conga. Well, one of them must have had a cold because he kept sneezing. So now they went, coo, coo, ka-choo. Why do hedgehogs just stop in the middle of the road? Pricks. I was on the quantum physics channel's version of Deal or No Deal. Want a dead cat? Well, on the repeat, I want a live cat. Now, I don't expect that many theoretical physicists to be in this. But believe me, in a parallel universe, you're all pissing yourselves. Now, I went past Wetherspoons one evening. There was this girl outside. She was having a piss in the street. Don't ask me why she didn't go inside the pub. Perhaps she's shy. Although the evidence would suggest otherwise. Because she was stooping between some dog shit and some broken glass. Looked like she was trying to build a fort. I mean, granted, it would have been a shit fort. At least it had windows. Albeit stained glass. Right, that one's too far. I'll leave you with this little bit of a story. One of my earliest memories was at the vets. I was there with my pet rabbit, Peter. Named him after Peter Rabbit. But the reason this memory stuck with me is the vet kept calling my mother by a maiden name instead of a married name, Mrs. Tomlinson. Well, this cropped up in conversation at work recently. We were talking about porn star names. Do you know where you take the name of your first pet, your mother's maiden name? That makes up your porn star name. So I retold the story about when I went to the vet's with my pet rabbit, Peter, and the vet kept calling my mother by her maiden name, Sutcliffe. It's a joke, obviously. My mother's maiden name wasn't Sutcliffe. It'd be ridiculous. Peter Sutcliffe. It was Stringfellow. Anyway, thank you for listening. Good night.